Okay, so this evening I'm going to speak about Lord Brahma avatar.
今天晚上我们来讲关于 avatar 这个化身。
Okay, so there's Lord Brahma, four-headed Brahma.
这图片上的是四个头的 Brahma.
So this section of the Srimad Bhagavatam continues. Lord Brahma wanted to see the universe populated.
这个主呢想要看这个宇宙的繁衍出现。
Lord Brahma, four-headed Brahma, you can see he's born from the lotus flower.
四个头的这个 Brahma 哈，梵天，他从这个莲花这样子展示出来。
And that lotus flower comes from the navel of Garbhodakashayi Vishnu.
那那个那朵莲花呢，是从这个孕蛋之羊韦斯牛的肚脐出现的。
Lord Vishnu is laying on the ocean in the bottom half of the universe.
主Vishnu呢，他住在就是宇宙的这个，宇宙的最底层。
And from his navel, the lotus flower comes.
然后从他的肚脐呢，生出了一朵莲花。
And Lord Brahma is born. He appears from that lotus flower.
然后 Brahma 呢，梵天就从那朵莲，这个肚脐出生的莲花出来了。
So Lord Brahma is the first living entity, the first born in the universe.
这 Brahma 呢，是宇宙的所谓第一个出生的生物。
And he is concerned to see the universe is populated.
然后他关心的是这个宇宙呢。 所以生物有繁衍出来。
So Lord Brahma is often considered the creator.
所以 Brahma 一般被认为是个创造者。
There's three gods, Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva.
通称有三个神，就是说 Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva.
Brahma is doing the creation. Vishnu is the maintainer and Shiva is the destroyer.
So Brahma 呢，他是就是说创造的时候的主管，然后呢 Vishnu 是维系的。
So Brahma is in charge of the mode of passion, and Vishnu is in charge of the mode of goodness, and Shiva is in charge of the mode of ignorance.
所以 Brahma 呢，就是主管激情属性。 Vishnu掌管的善良属性，然后 Shiva 呢掌管的是愚昧属性。So
to create, you have to have some passion.
所以要去创造呢，必须有一些激情。So
Brahma was thinking about how he could populate the universe, and at that time, from his body, two persons appeared.
所以 Brahma 就关心了这个宇宙的生物要怎么样来出生繁衍，and his bottom two living and become
two figures appeared from his body.
然后从他的身体呢出现两个形体。
One figure had a mustache.
哦，其中一个生物有胡须。
And the other figure had swollen breasts.
另外一个生物有一个肿胀的胸部。
So, they came from the body of Lord Brahma.
他们从 Brahma 的身体出现。
And their given the names Manu and Shatarupa.
所以他们那出现两个生物, 一个叫Manu, 一个叫Shatarupa.
So Manu is the position of Manu is important. In one day of Brahma, it said there's 14 Manus, 14 different.
在 Brahma 的一天里面呢，会出现14个 Manu.
So Manu is it's a position actually given. It means like the father of mankind.
Manu 实际上是一个地位，就是生物的父亲或是祖先这样来说。
There's a famous book called the Manu Samhita, which is the law book for mankind.
有一个有名的经典叫《Manu战歌》，那等于是人类的这个，就像六法全书一样，它是人类的律法。
So this is the first Manu in the day of Brahma. There's going to be other Manus after this one.
那现在出现这个长胡须的第一个 Manu 呢？是 在 Brahma 的14一天中14的 Manu 的第一个。
This first Manu is actually Swayambhuva Manu.
这第一个 Manu 实际上称为 Swayambhuva Manu.
And Manu, Swayambhuva Manu and Shatarupa together, they had children, they had a nice family, they had 2 sons and 3 daughters.
所以这个上面那个横的字是 Manu， 然后跟他的刚刚说那个肿胀的胸部的女子 Shatarupa， 他们两个呢就生了2个儿子，3个女儿。
The 2 sons, Priyavrata is very famous.
他两个儿子，其中一个第一个叫 Priyavrata 是非常有名的。
Priyavrata was very powerful, son of Manu. And Uttanapada, he was famous because he was the father of Dhruva, who was a great devotee.
那第二个儿子呢，Uttanapada是很有名，因为他是这个Dhruva那个小孩，那个小Dhruva的父亲。
And then 3 daughters, Akuti, Devahuti, Prashuti. Devahuti was, later on she was married and she had a child who was an incarnation of God, Lord Kapila.
那么三个女儿呢, Akuti, Devahuti, Prashuti. 那 Devahuti, 后来她结婚嫁了这个国王, 然后生了儿子叫做 Kapila.
Kapila taught the Sankhya philosophy.
那卡皮拉就是很有名的，就是教导数论瑜伽、桑杰罗哲学。
So you can see their children were very illustrious.
所以可以看到这些孩子们呢，也是非常有名的。
All right, so we're going to hear about the appearance of Lord Varaha, who is one of the 10 incarnations of Lord Vishnu.
所以我们要来看，现在是主 Varaha 的出现，他是主的10个化身之中的主要的10个化身之一。
There's a very famous song called the Gita Govinda.
有一个非常有名的歌曲叫 Gita Govinda.
And in the Gita Govinda, it begins with the glorification of the 10 avatars of Lord Vishnu.
Govinda之歌，哈，Gita Govinda， 那首先的第一首就是先讲荣耀主的10个化身。
So Lord Varaha is one of these 10 avatars.
所以主 Varaha 是这10个化身之一，主要的啊，是主的10个化身。
Varaha actually means boar, the boar incarnation.
Varaha 实际上指的是说猪啊，豪猪的化身。
And we should understand how Lord Vishnu can appear in many different forms.
那我们同时也应该来了解，主 Vishnu 可以有很多不同的形体来出现。
Sometimes he will come in the form of a fish, known as the Matsya Avatar.
有些时候主呢会以鱼的身体出现，那他那时候名称叫 Matsya Avatar. apparition.
Sometimes he comes as in the form of a turtle, known as Kurma Avatar.
有时候他以这个乌龟的形体出现哈,
and then you can come in a half man, half lion.
然后也可以以半人半狮的形体出现.
So Lord Vishnu is not limited to any special form. He can come in any form he likes.
所以主Vishnu不会被限制在任何形体内, 他可以以他自己喜欢而以任何形体出现.
Now when we think of a boar, you know, wild boars or pigs, they're not very pleasant creatures, you know, we want to keep away from them or get rid of them.
所以当我们想到说猪的话,我们觉得 哎，这不是一个很愉快的情况，就是猪的状况，我们可以去想到。
But there's a special reason why Lord Vishnu takes the form of a boar.
但是呢，主Vishnu为什么来接受一个豪猪的形体呢？是有理由的。
And we should understand when Lord Vishnu comes as a boar, that he is not like an ordinary boar. He is transcendental. He's attractive.
所以当我们看到主Vishnu猪的形体出现，那个猪不是一般的猪，是一种超然的一种形，超然的。
One of the artists had the job to paint pictures to showing the activities, illustrating the pastimes of Lord Varaha.
有一个艺术家呢，他的工作是在画画主的这个 Varaha， 他的主会画画，然后画的主 Varaha猪的这个形体化身。
So she asked her teacher Prabhupada about how to draw Lord Varaha, because she said usually boars are not very good looking things, but this boar is to be Lord Vishnu.
所以这个艺术家就问这个主Vishnu说，那么如果主是以豪猪的身体出现，那要怎么画呢？因为一般看到猪的样子， 让人家觉得不是那么愉快或是不好的感觉。
But Prabhupada told her, yes, he said, you have to make him as attractive as possible.
所以Prabhupada说是啊，猪的形体就是让人觉得是那种样子，那么你就尽量画的让人们，就说让会吸引人的那个样子。
Anyway, the chapter begins in Srimad Bhagavatam, begins with Lord Brahma instructing Swayambhuva Manu and his wife that they have to create progeny. Lord Brahma had produced Manu and Satarupa, and he asked them to help him to fill up the universe and produce progeny.
所以在Buddha瓦坛里面呢，就首先开始呢， Brahma 来训示 这个 Swayambhuva Manu 还有他的老婆 Satarupa 来创造繁衍生物。
So Lord Brahma asked to create progeny, and Manu responded to Brahma's request by saying to Brahma that, well, we have to have some place to live, you know, that, but the earth planet at that time had fallen into the bottom of the universe.
所以马努就说，对呀，可是我们要创造生物，必须有个地方可以住，因为在那个时候，这个地球已经掉到这个宇宙海洋的最底层了。You
have to understand that the universe is like an egg.
那我们要来了解这个一个宇宙就像一个卵形，一个很大的一个蛋。And
it's, you know, the shell of the egg represents the different layers of the universe.
然后这个蛋的外壳就代表宇宙的各个阶段层，一层一层的膜一样。
And within that egg, you have this water at the bottom of the universe, and you have Vishnu laying there on the water, the lotus flower coming.
然后在这个很大的这个卵里面的 下面就是下半部就像是这个水海洋这样子，那Vishnu躺在那边。So
the planets were meant to be resting around the lotus flower, but somehow the earth planet had fallen into the bottom of the ocean, the bottom of the universe.
本来这些宇宙应该是在连，就是 坐落在这个莲花上面，可是不知道呢，像这个地球啊，它就掉到这个宇宙的底层，就是这宇宙海洋的底部。那我们可以看到吗？T-sport. One of my T-sports.
It's okay.
No, but when I speak, the sound goes a lot out. So the pronunciation
was... I don't have a mask. I don't have a mask. I don't have a
mask.
So the earth had fallen. So Manu asked Brahma, can you please pick up that earth planet from the bottom of the earth?
哎，所以曼努就要求 Brahma 就说，你可以把这个地球从宇宙底层抬起来吗？
So here you can see Lord Varaha, transcendental form.
所以我们可以看到 Varaha 这个超然的形体。
And on this resting on his tusk, you can see that represents the Earth planet.
啊，所以呢，在这个 Varaha 这个豪猪哈、啊、主的这个形体豪猪。
So the Srimad Bhagavatam describes that while Lord Brahma was thinking about how to pick up the earth from the bottom of the universe, at that time a small boar came out of its nostril.
在国家瓦盘里面描述了，就是说这个生物跟 Brahma 的。那就从这个豪猪 Varaha 的鼻孔里面生出了一只，就是出现了一只小猪。
Yeah, it's as small as a thumb. The upper portion of a thumb.
那就从它鼻孔出现的一只小猪呢，小的比它的拇指还要小，比那个猪的指甲的还要小。
Try to understand this situation. This Lord Varaha is taking his appearing from the nostril of Lord Brahma.
So, 试着来了解他从 Varaha's nose.
Varaha comes from Brahma's nose.
Oh, so, Varaha is from
And he's very small coming out from the nose, but he grows quickly to a gigantic form like a great elephant. And coming out from the nostril of Brahma, Lord Varaha then dives into the ocean, that water which is at the bottom of the universe.
那么，他从这个 Brahma 的鼻子出现之后，又长得很快，然后他就很快在潜入这个，就是说我们刚刚说这个宇宙的海洋。
And Lord Varaha is searching after the earth. How to find the earth? It's in the bottom of the universe. There's a lot of things. Dirt is very at the bottom of the universe. How could he find out the Earth planet? He was able to locate the Earth simply by the sense of smell.
这个祖玛拉哈就在想说，那这样子地球已经把它举起来，可是要放在哪里了？因为那时候这个整个所谓这个宇宙这个。云淡海洋啊，还有底层啊，就是很脏乱啊，这样子。
And this is one reason why Lord Vishnu took the form of the boar, because that form of the boar was, the boar has a very strong sense of smell.
那这就是主为什么以这个一只猪的形体出现，因为猪呢，它的感官里面这个嗅觉非常的敏锐。
So Lord Varaha took the earth planet onto his tusks and took it out from the bottom of the universe.
所以就是这个啊， Varaha 用他的这个鼻尖，这个猪脚、猪的牙齿，这样把这个地球从宇宙底层这样抬起来。
Oh. all of the planets, they rest in the bottom of the universe at the end of Brahma's, each of Brahma's day. The end of Brahma's day is a partial devastation, not a total devastation.
那Brahma梵天的这个毁，我们说毁灭，它叫做它那一天结束的时候，只是整个宇宙毁灭的一个部分，不是完全的毁灭。
Not all the planets were
going to be.
And then the chapter goes on to describe about how the people, the residents in the higher planet, up in Satya Loka, they offer Vedic hymns to glorify Lord
Brahma.
On this planet Satyaloka, which is way up at the top of the universe, far above heaven and far above the earthly planet we're on, the residents there are all very enlightened in spiritual
knowledge. 那里的居民呢，都是很多已经是所谓觉悟的哈，启发的这些灵魂。
So they could recognize that boar. They could understand that boar was no ordinary boar. They understood this was an avatar of Lord Vishnu, and they began to recite Vedic hymns to glorify.
那在那边的星球里面的居民呢，因为自信很高，领悟力已经很强了，所以他们可以辨认出这个。 这一只所谓山猪形体的组织很特别的，不是一般的，所以他们就可以来朗诵出伟大的这些赞歌，来赞扬这主。So
the Lord had appeared in the form of a boar for two purposes. One purpose was to pick the earth up from the bottom of the universe, and the other purpose was to kill a demon called Hiranyaksha.
所以主Varaha这只山猪的化身出现有两个理由，一个呢是把地球从宇宙的底层把它抬起来，另外呢第二个理由是要来杀掉恶魔Hiranyaksha。And
after Lord Varaha done these things, then he returned to his own abode, which is not in this material world, it's beyond the material.
瓦拉哈完成了这项这两件任务之后呢，他就回到他自己的星球，他的星球呢，是超越物质世界的。So
it's pointed out that actually there are two incarnations of Varaha. One is the white Varaha, and the other is the red Varaha.
所以呢，说到这个Varaha豪猪呢的化身是有两个，一个是身体是白色的，另外一个是红色的。So
the white Varaha was the one who picked up the earth from the bottom of the universe, and the red Varaha is the one which killed Hiranyaksha.
所以白色那一只呢，是把地球。 拯救抬起来的红色那一只呢，是把这个恶魔Hiranyaksha杀掉的。When
people see this kind of illustration, Lord Varaha is there fighting with the demon Hiranyaksha. They're often confused about which one is the good person and which one is the bad
person.所以这个图片出现的时候呢，人们觉得很困惑，就想哪一个是好人，哪一个是坏人这样。
You can see Lord Varaha appearing in the form of a boar. To ordinary people, they think it must be the demon.
看到这个主Varaha出现是一个猪的形体,
Actually, it's the other way around. The human form is a demon called Hiranyaksha.
但实际上正好相反，那个旁边那个人体的这个，他才是恶魔，人形的，他是Hiranyaksha。
Lord Varaha, Lord Vishnu, has taken the form of the boar simply for the purpose of his pastime.
就是Vishnu，他展示出这个猪的形体呢，只是为了进行他的逍遥活动。
So in the Srimad Bhagavatam, we then hear about how Diti, one of the wives of Kashyapa, becomes pregnant in the evening.
然后佛教王来继续讲的就是说，这个Kashyapa的其中一个老婆Diti呢，她的怀孕。The
Srimad Bhagavatam is describing the meeting between two great personalities, Vidura and Maitreya. And Vidura met with Maitreya to hear from Maitreya, to question him about different matters.
在这边这个瓦坎继续讲到两个人物，一个是Vidura，一个是Maitreya。然后呢，Vidura就来询问着这跟Maitreya询问。So,
one of the questions which Vidura asked Maitreya was, what was the reason for the fight between the demon, this demon Hiranyaksha, and Lord Varaha the boar?
那，Vidura首先问的问题就是说，这个主的豪猪化身，为什么要跟这个恶魔这样子开始，恶魔这样作战 Hiranyaksha？
So, it's described how Maitreya tells how Diti had approached her husband Kashyapa, requesting him to satisfy her sexual desire.
So Maitreya, 他就回答了，他说是因为这个Diti，这个，他就要求他的丈夫来满足他个人的欲望。
So her husband was a great sage, and he requested Diti that, certainly, as your husband, it is my duty to satisfy you, but kindly just wait, because the time just now, the evening, just the day is changing to evening, it is not an auspicious time.
那这个开始吧，就跟他说，他这个老婆弟弟说，当然啦，身为你的丈夫，这是我的责任要来满足你，可是因为现在是 白天跟黄昏交接的时段，不是不吉祥的。你再稍等，这个时段过了之后。
So Kashyapa had asked his wife, just kindly wait until this inauspicious time is over. But regrettably, Diti was not able to control her desires.
然后接着呢，当然Kashyapa就是说把这些。 告诉他的老婆，在这个时候要进行关系呢，是不吉祥的。可是当时他的老婆没有办法，就是没办法等了。And
her husband also had to give in to her and satisfy her desire.
那因为这老婆心意太受干扰了，所以这个丈夫就必须要来。 丈夫就必须要去安他老婆，要跟着老婆的情绪。So
after the conception, Kashyapa told his wife that everything was inauspicious.
那当他们两个圆转了之后，这丈夫呢，Kashyapa就跟老婆啊，这个弟弟说。 我们刚刚的这些事都是在不吉祥的时候进行的，那一切就是不吉祥的。And
the result of our conception is that you will give birth to two sons who will be very cruel, and they'll torture women, and they'll they will even kill people who have no fault.
Mm-hmm. 然后呢，会去骚扰，会去欺负女子，然后会骚扰别人啊。对于没有理由要杀的人，他们也去杀害。
Finally, the Lord Vishnu will come, and he will kill.
然后呢，之后主就会再出现，然后来把这个两个儿子杀掉。
So the wife Diti, she was feeling it. First, she felt very bad, but hearing that the Lord would personally come and kill them, she felt some relief.
那这个老婆Diti听到就觉得，当然很难过，可是又想说，主会亲自来把他的两个孩子杀掉，也是一种拯救吧。
Anyway, Diti had conceived these sons within her womb, and she'd heard from her great husband that they would be demons and give trouble to the universe. So she didn't want to give birth to them, and she tried to keep them in her womb for a long time.
那这个妻子呢，弟弟他听到丈夫这样跟他说，他们生出来儿子会是恶魔，而且要被主杀掉，那因为会是恶魔的孩子，所以他很不愿意把这孩子生出来。
So because Didi was keeping these two children in her womb, it affected the whole universe, and the whole universe became dark.
那因为这个弟弟把他的婴儿留在腹中，一直没有把他生出来，那这也干扰了整个宇宙，那宇宙就变得一片昏暗。
So when the universe became very black, then all the demigods could not understand what was wrong, and they approached Lord Brahma to ask him, what's happening?
那因为这两个孩子没生出来，然后天地一片黑暗，那就Brahma问着主说，到底发生了什么事呢？
And Lord Brahma told the demigods how his four sons, you can see in the picture there, the four sons, the four Kumaras, the four young boys who are naked there, these are the four sons of Brahma called the four Kumaras. They were trying to enter into Vaikuntha, but they were stopped at the gate to Vaikuntha by the two doorkeepers. One is called Jaya and the other is Vijaya.
那半神人们问了Brahma半天，来解释这些事情的情况。那Brahma对他们来解释的，就是说 Brahma 自己的四个孩子，我们图片看到的这个四个小孩，被称为四个 Kumara，那他们想要进到 Vaikuntha 去，但是呢被 Vaikuntha 的两个守门者 Jaya 跟 Vijaya 这两个人来挡在门口。
If you go to a Vishnu temple, generally you'll find at the door of the Vishnu temple there will be these two men, Jaya and Vijaya. They're the gatekeepers at Vaikuntha. Vaikuntha means the spiritual world. So the four Kumaras, they're the sons of Brahma, and they had the right, they were liberated souls, they had the right to enter into the spiritual world.
他们有权利进入灵性世界，因为他们
They were liberated souls.
因为他们是已经解脱的灵魂。So
they can go wherever they like.
他们已经解脱了呢，所以随处都可以想去哪里就去哪里。
But the two gatekeepers, Jai and Vijay, they saw these four young boys coming naked and they thought, how could these four children be qualified to come into the spiritual world? And they stopped them from coming in.
那这两个守门者呢，加尔就看着这四个四个小孩过来，而且全身赤裸裸的、光光的身体，就想说他们怎么有资格进来这里呢？ 那就把他们挡在门口。So
the four Kumaras, they were upset that these two gatekeepers, they think we're not qualified to come into the spiritual world.
因为这个四个小孩呢，就是四 Kumara 就在想着说，他们这两个守门者认为我们没有资格可以进来来 Kuntama。
And they thought that we think these two gatekeepers are not really qualified to be there as gatekeepers.
那这四个 Kumara 想着说，这两个守门者应该没有资格在这边当守门的。
We've come all the way through the material universe. We've come to the spiritual world, and we've come here to the spiritual planet, and we're entering, and they won't let us in the gate.
那我们一路呢，穿越了物质世界，来到这边要进到灵性世界的大门了。结果呢，他们把我们挡在门口。So
the four Kumaras considered that these two gatekeepers are not they need to go to the material world. They're not qualified to be there in the spiritual.
那这四个 Kumara 呢，就认为这两个守门呢。 没有资格留在这边守的这个守卫，他们应该去到物质世界里。So
they pushed them that they should fall to the material world.
所以他们四个 Kumara 就认为这两个守门应该先要掉进去物质世界里。So
the Srimad Bhagavatam continues that when the four Kumaras were arguing with the two gatekeepers. At that time, Lord Vishnu came. Lord Vishnu is known as Padmanabha.
So, this Kumara,
Lord Vishnu, Lord Padmanabha, he's carrying the aroma of tulsi leaves. His lotus feet are decorated with the leaves of the tulsi.
So when Padmanabha comes out, he carries a scent with him. That means it's the tulsi leaves.
And that aroma from the tulsi leaves entered into the nostrils of the four Kumaras. And with that aroma entering into their nostrils, the four Kumaras had a change from impersonal to personal understanding.
那当这图拉西的香气呢，进到他们的鼻子后，他们就有一种改变，本来是非人格的主义者，现在变成人格主义的这种。
Yeah, the four Kumaras initially were attracted to the impersonal feature of the Lord.
这个四个 Kumara 他们先前呢是被主的非人格的部分所吸引。They
had heard about the Lord from their father, Lord Brahma.
他们从他们的父亲 Brahma 那边听说过主的事情。But
somehow they were not attracted. They were more attracted to this impersonal feature.
但是呢，他们没有受到吸引，他们反而被那个非人格的部分所吸引着。But
when they actually met with the Lord, when Lord Vishnu actually came there, and they saw him and the smell of the tulsi leaves entered, then they had a change in heart.
但是他们有亲自见到了主，然后闻到主脚趾散出来的土拉西的香气，然后经过他们的鼻孔这样吸进去之后，他们从非人格主义的变成人格主义的。
So we want to understand the significance of Lord Brahma appearing first of all from the nostril of Brahma, and then in the form of a boar.
所以我们要来了解主巴拉玛拉哈出现的这个重要性。首先呢，就是说，从 Brahma 的鼻孔的这个部分，然后主为什么是以这个猪的形体出现
？So we should understand that the Vedic sound enters into Lord Brahma. It's the breath of the Lord.
在我们来了解，就是说，那个音，超然的声音进到 Brahma 的耳朵的这个呢，实际上是主的呼吸。
And so when Lord Varaha appears from the nostril of Brahma, Lord Varaha is a manifestation of the Vedic knowledge.
所以那个。
Lord Varaha is the form of the Vedic knowledge.
So Varaha is Vedic knowledge.
And it comes from the nostril, from the breathing of Brahma.
So Varaha is from Brahma's
And it takes the form of a boar. The significance of the boar is to pick up something from a dirty place.
然后它出现为一个猪的形体的意思是说，它是就是说，把生物从肮脏的地方提升起来。
And remember, the boar has the art of a strong sense of smell. And he could detect the earth by its smell.
所以呢，这个猪的鼻子的嗅觉特别灵敏，所以它的能力呢，可以去分辨这个东西的品质而去挑选。
And then we want to understand also about the two brothers, Hiranyaksha and Hiranyakashipu.
同时我们接着来了解那个两兄弟。 就是讲到Hiranyaksha跟Hiranyakashipu。
So Hiranyaksha was born first, so and he was considered younger than Hiranyakashipu.
He was born first, but considered younger.
Hiranyaksha was born first, and but he's considered younger. Why? You should understand why.
那么Hiranyaksha是 先出生的，可是被认为是比较年幼、年轻的。我们必须要去了解为什么。
When the mother conceives twins, the first child enters, then another child.
哦，如果一个母亲呢，她受孕，双胞胎的这个胚胎的话，就是出来的时候是一个一个。
So the one who is conceived first in the womb is the last one to come out.
就是被先受孕的胚胎呢，是比较后来才所以分娩生出来。So
Hiranyaksha was born first. He entered the womb first, but he came out
after. 所以Hiranyaksha呢，就是说，他先生出来。 但在受孕的过程，它是比较后的，后来的，所以它就是变成比较属于，就像弟弟一样，小弟。
In Chinese, when they have twins, one is called Dada, and the other is called Xiao Xiao.
Maybe in China.
Yeah, in China.
Yeah, 在大陆呢，他们比较传统的双胞胎兄弟。 一个叫大大，一个叫小小。
大大 means The oldest one.
我们就知道大哥这个哈。 是比较年长啊。哎，这个是一样的，because she's the first one to come out，right？那其实，这个其实应该是她是小的，因为她先，所以先，生出来，但实际上受孕的时候，她是比较，早一点哈，就是晚一点，受孕，是慢生的，是早一点受孕。
When Lord Brahma picked up the earth from the bottom of the universe, he floated it on the water. How was he able to do that? Simply by the potency of the
Lord. 那当这个地球哈，我们宇宙里面这个地球，它是怎么有办法在这个宇宙的海洋这个水体上面浮着呢？这完全是主的仁慈。
And how is the Lord distinguished from all the other residents of Vaikuntha? Yeah, Lord Padmanabha, Lord Narayan, is different from all the other people at Vaikuntha because he has a special distinguishing mark on his chest, which is the hair of Sri Vatsa.
然后在那一篇的19章15节里面又说到主在这个Vaikuntha星球怎么样跟那边的生物来分辨呢？那这就是说主即使在Vaikuntha星球，Vaikuntha也有星球里面的居民。那主呢，他身体有一些特别的特征，跟其他的生物不一样。
You go to Vaikuntha, everyone has four arm forms.
如果真的去到Vaikuntha，我们知道呢，Vaikuntha的居民都有四只手。
And many people, they have the Swarupa Mukti, they have the liberation into a form like the Lord.
而且在Vaikuntha星球，有一些生物呢，他们得到其中的一种解脱，就是跟主一样的身体身形。
So if you go into Vaikuntha, how will you distinguish who is actually the Lord and who are the devotees?
所以如果你去到Vaikuntha，你怎么样去分辨？ 到底谁是主和谁是奉献者呢？
Everyone is the same age. There's no old people. There's no young. Everyone is the same age.
在Vaikuntha，在那儿所有的生物都是所有的人都同年龄，没有比较年轻的，没有比较年老的。
So the Lord is distinguished himself. One is by the hair of Srivatsa on his chest. And the other, because he wears around his neck a very special necklace called the Kastuba
necklace.那一个呢，就有两个，在昆达两个特征啊，就是说，有一他挂了一条特别的项链，是Kastuba这种宝石所做的项链，and another is one in the chest.
Kastuba, Kastuba,
yeah. Yeah, and first one was.
The hair on the chest, a white hair on the chest. Another question, what happened to Diti, the mother, before the death of her demonic son?
那这个刚刚这个Diti就是她生了这两个恶魔的孩子之后，她
And so, before the her son was killed by Lord Varaha, but just shortly before he died, Diti was, blood was flowing from her breast instead of milk.
那个时候就是这个Diti，他本来胸部应该是溢出这个奶汁给孩子吃，可是他却溢从他胸部溢出了这个血，这样。
Alright, so another point we want to understand about is Manu's acceptance of Lord Brahma's order. We were telling how Manu was born from Brahma, so Brahma was like father to Manu.
这个 Brahma 他生出了14个 Manu 哈，而这个 Manu 啊，实际上 Brahma 等于是 Manu 的父亲。
And Manu was given the order by Lord Brahma that he should help to populate the universe.
所以呢 ，Manu 就受到 Brahma 的这个命令，就是说应该来这个宇宙里面来繁衍生物。
And Manu accepts the order and is eager to carry out the instruction given to him by Brahma, his father.
所以 Manu 呢接受 Brahma 的这个命令哈，就等于接受父亲的命令。
So that cooperation between the father and the son, that is very important to, and it's very good for society to see that kind of cooperative spirit between the father and the son.
所以这个父亲跟孩子的合作非常重要，也是这样整个宇宙才能和谐的这样子的所谓功用进行。
The father and the son want to cooperate. Certainly the father will take care of the son while he's very young, but as soon as the son grows up and is able to take care of himself, then the son has a duty to assist the father.
所以呢父亲跟孩子们的合作很重要啊，这个当孩子年轻的时候，很小的时候，父亲自然会照顾这些孩子们。但想这个孩子长大一点，长大的时候，自然可以来继续接承父亲的一起工作，协助这个父亲。
But in contrast to Manu's acceptance of Brahma, we saw how the four Kumaras rejected the order from Lord Brahma.
而我们接着又看到呢。马努他接受 Brahma 的命令，可是这个四个 Kumara 却拒绝这个Brahma 的命令。
The four Kumaras were the very first sons of Brahma.
这个四个 Kumara 是 Brahma 最首先生出的这个孩子。
And Lord Brahma requested the Kumaras, "I want you to help me to populate the universe."
那 Brahma 也就是说跟这四个 Kumara 说，我要你们来繁衍宇宙的生物。
But the four Kumara said, "No, we don't want to do that."
而这四个 Kumara 说，不要，我们不要做这事。
We're going to stay as young children all of our life.
我们就想一生都是啊。保留在一个孩子的这样的身形状况。
We're not going to change our physical form. We're going to remain like young children.
我们不想改变我们人体的样子，我们只要留在这孩子的形体。
So even though the four Kumaras are the oldest personalities in the universe, they look like young children.
所以呢，即使这四个 Kumara 是宇宙最老的生物，可是他们一直看起来就好像是那些小孩一样。
And that's why they got restricted when they went to Vaikuntha. Jai and Vijay thought, "Oh, these are just children. How could they be qualified to ever come into the spiritual world?"
啊，因为他们那张小孩的样子啊。也会让这刚刚说到在瓦昆达门口的守门者把他们挡住，他们想说他们只是一般普通小孩。
Jai and Vijay, the two gatekeepers, they did not know that these are the sons of Brahma. These are the first sons of Brahma.
刚才守门Jai and Vijay他们根本不知道呢，他们这四个孩子是 Brahma 的第一批孩子。
So the four Kumaras, they refused the order of Lord Brahma, but they were not wrong.
而这四个 Kumara 灵性的进步。
They thought that if we have to follow the order of our father, we'll get entangled in so many affairs and maintaining a family and so many, it will be very difficult for us to pursue our path of enlightenment.
那这么四个小孩呢，他们想说如果我们接受父亲的命令来繁衍后代的话呢，我们就会被物质上的各种责任跟义务捆绑着啊，我们就会在我们要领悟解脱的道路上 产生很大的障碍。
If we have to enter into the family life and have a lot of children, how will we ever be able to meditate peacefully?
如果我们有家庭生活，然后养着小孩啊，那你又怎么办？怎么可以有所谓心平气和的来冥想呢？
We'll never be able to achieve our spiritual destiny.
在这样子各种繁杂的事物中呢，我们永远没办法到达我们灵性的目的。
So they apologized to their father and told him that we're sorry, we can't accept your order.
所以他们就跟他们的父亲抱歉，说我们没办法来接受你的命令。
And Lord Brahma is not very happy, but what can he do about it? Because they have a higher purpose in mind.
Brahma, 他听的当然是不高兴，可是他能怎么办呢？因为这些孩子有更高的宗旨，更高的目标。
In the Vedic culture, you're supposed to follow Varnashram. You're supposed to move progressively from one ashram to another.Means from student, you're supposed to move into family life, and then later on, then renounce.
因为在美达的文化里面呢，就有这个社会阶层、灵性跟社会的这种系统，那就是要一步一步来。你要先从单身的然后变成居士，然后再后来云游，再脱婚去这样子。
But the four Kumaras, they wanted to immediately to renounce.
而这四个 Kumara, 他们想要马上就进到弃绝的生活。
And so Lord Brahma cannot refuse them. He doesn't want to stop them, but at the same time, he's not very happy.
Brahma 呢是没办法拒绝他们，因为他们想要直接去弃绝，但是这样他接受，但是稍微还是有点，所以他有点。
And so we understand the importance of Manu's acceptance, being faithful, being obedient to the father is very good. It helps to cooperation between the family.
所以我们可以来了解这些原则的重要性。像这个Manu接受父亲的命令来很好的去所谓繁衍生物哈，就是说让整个社会可以传承下去。
But the four Kumaras not accepting Brahma's order is also okay because they have a higher purpose in mind. They want to perfect their self-realization.
那么四个 Kumara 他们没有接受这样的命令也是可以的，因为他们有更高的目标，就是想要到达自我觉悟。
So in our Krishna consciousness movement, you get both situations.
所以我们在 Krishna 知觉运动里面也是都可以有这两种情形的。
Some people come to Krishna consciousness. They want to, and they don't. They're happy to enter into family life and take their responsibility.
有些人来到 Krishna 知觉呢，他们也是有着接受家庭的生活，而且有一些人是快乐的家庭生活。
But sometimes you do get some people who just want to pursue the path of self-realization.
而我们有时候在这个运动里面也会有一些人，他们只是想要得到自我觉悟这样的目标。
They don't want to enter into the family life and take up the responsibilities for these things.
那就只想朝着灵性自我觉悟的方向，不去接受这个家庭生活啦，然后要被家庭的义务跟责任所牵绊。
So both situations are acceptable.
所以这两种情况都是可以接受的。
Usually women, they have to get married.
一般来讲，女子们，女孩都要结婚。
But men, they don't have to get married.
但同时男孩呢，男子不要结婚，那怎么调和呢？
Find more men.
再去多培养一些男的风间。
Okay, so Prabhupada explains. If you get married, if you take married life, then it's a responsibility, you're responsible to satisfy Lord Vishnu.
啊, 包括就解释了, 就说一个人接受了这个婚姻生活呢, 就要接受, 要来满足自尊主的这样的责任。
And that is the first stepping stone in the Varnashram system.
那这样子呢, 就是在我们美达的社会系统里面的第一个踏脚石。
Entering into the family life, that is the, one of the steps of the Varnashram.
所以进入家庭生活是在Varnashram灵性跟社会阶段的第一个踏脚石。
It's a responsibility.
是责任。
And that responsibility is to satisfy the Supreme Lord Vishnu.
所以进入居士, 啊, 他的责任就是, 也是要满足这个至尊主。
But at the same time, if somebody wants to just simply concentrate on devotional service, he doesn't have to go through all of that.
那如果, 一个人只想直接的进入奉爱服务的程序呢, 那他就不需要经过刚刚说的那种居家居士生活。
Somebody just wants to be renounced and be, stay away from the responsibilities of these, of this, then if they're able to control their mind and senses and behave properly, then they can do it.
那有一些人他们只想说专注在这个 奉献服务啦，达到自我觉悟这些情况，如果说他们可以做到的话，可以控制自己的感官心意哈，这样子也是可以的。
So in, simply engage in devotional service, hearing and chanting.
这样子就是说，完全专注于聆听跟聆听啊，念诵这些事。
Here you can see Lord Varaha fighting with the demon Hiranyaksha. So it's described Hiranyaksha was he was a very powerful demon. But when he came to fight with Lord Varaha, he was just like a doll.
玛拉哈面前跟他打斗，他只像一个小娃娃，或是。The
children will break the doll without any, very easy to break the doll.
如果小孩玩那个洋娃娃呢，很容易把洋娃娃折断啊，弄坏。So
the demon appeared to be very powerful to ordinary people in the material world, but not to the Lord.
所以恶魔在一般人的面前，在一般人眼界里认为很有力量，可是，在主的面前就完全不是了。
The Lord Vishnu comes, he can kill the demon without any difficulty.
那么主出现在这个恶魔面前呢，是毫不费费之力就把恶魔杀了。
Can kill many demons, just like the child can play with dolls.
而且主可以同时杀掉很多恶魔，就很像这小孩子玩的那个小娃娃、洋娃娃一样。So
we get special merit hearing about this pastime, the appearance of Lord Varaha.
所以我们聆听着这主Varaha的显现呢，我们得到特别的。
There's always some fruit from hearing about the different pastimes which are described in scriptures.
那我们聆听的这个主的各种化身的这些活动呢，这些出现呢，都在伟达经典里面描述，聆听者呢会获得特别的恩惠。
So this pastime of Lord Varaha, it gives us special merit. It gives us, it can bestow on us special wealth and fame and long life, everything you could desire.
那聆听的主啊的显现的这个小时光呢，一个人可以得到他的愿望满足，不管他要财富啦、力量啦、地位啦或什么。
And if you're involved in a battle, Maybe you're having to take part in battle, then it gives you, it gives strength to your vital organs. And if we hear this pastime at the end of life, just as you're leaving the body, then you will be transferred to the spiritual world.
那如果呢，我们在这个临终临死之前呢，聆听的这个消息光呢，我们就可以啊离开躯体，灵魂转化到去灵性世界。
In the same way, if we hear the Srimad Bhagavatam, where this narration is taken from, that it's all about different pastimes of the Lord.
所以同样的道理，如果我们这样子的聆听，持继续的聆听圣典摩迦瓦坛，完全充满着主的夏尔时光，这样子呢，在我们生命中了的时候，肯定可以啊被转化到永恒主的永恒超然的星球。
Yes, at the end of life, it's important for us to be able to fix the mind on the Lord.
所以在我们生命啊生命终了，就是临终前啊，这个事情很重要，就是我们要练习到能够把心意专注在主的身上。And
we can be transferred to the Lord's abode.
啊，在那种临终前，我们专注于主的话呢。
So we can be benefited in two ways. One way is that while we're living in this world, we can be greatly benefited. And at the end of life, also we can be
benefited. 那么在临终前呢，就可以直，还有就是可以直接进到灵性世界。So
this is the result of hearing the pastime of Lord Brahma.
所以这是聆听这个主 Varaha 的夏尔时光的结果。All
right, so we've explained here about the appearance of Lord Varaha and this pastime.
所以我们刚刚描述了主 Varaha 的这个出现的夏尔时光。
And we spoke about the example of Manu and his obedience to the order of Lord Brahma.
我们也说到，Manu呢，他就是遵守孝顺的遵守他父亲Brahma的命令。
And then the four Kumaras and how they could legitimately reject the order of their father.
然后呢，我们也看到了这个Kumara，这四个Kumara。 他们是被支持的，可以去拒绝这个父亲的这个命令，是他们有这样正确的理由。This
demon Hiranyaksha, he displayed very special demoniac qualities. As we said, he was terrorizing innocent women, torturing women, and killing innocent people.
那这个恶魔居然亚沙，我们刚描述他是这么残暴，欺负女子们呐，然后去虐待他们呐，还有去杀害无辜的人。And
he was extremely powerful, and he went everywhere looking for battle to find someone who could give him a good fight.
那居然亚沙也是这么粗暴的到各地去挑战啊，去想要找地方找人跟他一起打。
And at one point he went to Lord Varuna, who is the god of the ocean. And but he asked Varuna to give him a fight, but Varuna said, no, I'm too old now, I won't be able to give you a good fight. But he said, don't worry, in the future there's a personality of Godhead, Lord Vishnu will come, he'll give you a good fight.
Varuna 你不担心呢、啊？以后呢，这个至尊主呢，他会出现，亲自来跟你打斗。
It's also mentioned that there's a connection between the disturbances which go on the planet and how these disturbances are related to the increase in demonic population.
嗯，然后接着有描述到，就是说这个在宇宙各个星球持续不断的这些纷争战争的出现呢，也是由于很多恶魔性格的人跟生物一直不断的繁衍的。
Next time there's a big disturbance on the planet, maybe earthquake or tremors or tsunami, things like that.These kind of disturbances, they are they're indicating that some demonic persons are taking over.
如果将来呢，就之后呢，如果地球上有很大的灾难啊，非常巨大的地震啊，海啸啊，龙卷风啊，或什么，这表示有很邪恶、很罪恶的生物出现，就是诞生。
Okay, so are there any questions?
各位有任何问题吗？
Anybody, any comment?
任何人有任何意见吗？
Lord Varaha worship is quite popular in South India.
在南印度呢，去崇拜 Varaha 也是很普遍的。
In the past, even there was a region in South India where they had their own currency, and their currency was Varaha.
那过去在南印度呢，有一个地区，他们有自己的货币，然后他们的货币呢是这个 Varaha.
We have dollars, you know, but in the past we had Varaha.
我们有这个一块两块这个什么美元台币或什么什么币，那他们是 Varaha.
So Lord Varaha is commonly worshipped with, maybe like Lord Narsingadeva is worshipped also. Lord Narsingadeva is more popular, you may think, but actually in the past Lord Varaha was much more popular.
我们也有这个崇拜尼辛格德的人呢，那在南印度也是很多人崇拜尼辛格德，但实际上呢，在之前是 Varaha 是更加的普遍，更
You can get a lot of blessings.
然后啊，去崇拜这个 Varaha 会得到很多的祝福。
And so Jayadeva Goswami, who wrote the Gita Govinda, he had composed the Das Avatar Stotra. And in the Das Avatar Stotra, Lord Varaha is mentioned there.
那 Jayadeva Goswami 他写了这个 Gita Govinda, 就是 Govinda 之歌哈。这个里面对提了十个化身的赞颂，那 Varaha 也被提到了。
Okay, any question, anyone? Any devotees of Lord Varaha here?
这里有没有 Varaha 的这个奉献的崇拜 Varaha 的？
You can sing the Das Avatar Stotra every day if you like. Worship all the 10 avatars.
如果你也可以来这个每天来念诵主的十个化身这个赞歌哈。
There are actually many avatars.
实际上主的化身是很多很多的。
But Jayadeva Goswami wrote about 10 principal ones.
那Jayadeva Goswami他写了十个主要的化身。
And Lord Krishna, he is avatari. He's not avatar. He's the source of all that.
那昆沙称为 avatari， 就是说，他不是 avatar， 他是这些化身的源头。
They're all coming from.
所有的化身都是来自于 Krishna。
Who is the women marry?
Don't go to the women.
But a few special men, like the four Kumaras, they want to stay young forever. Well, we're learning about the Lord. How there's a supreme personality who is maintaining the universe, maintaining the universal order. When things go wrong in the world, we're learning also. Well, there are many points we brought out today. We were saying the cause of natural disturbances, the natural disturbances is related to the birth of demonic people. And we heard about why Diti gave birth to two demons, why her two children were demons. She didn't follow the instructions of her husband. Her husband was trying to tell her this is not an auspicious time.
因为她的丈夫有事地跟她说，那个时候并不是吉祥的时候。
So that's one instruction for us.
那对我们来讲也是一个训示。
We should understand there are things like sometimes are auspicious and sometimes are not auspicious.
所以我们必须知道，做事情有些时候是吉祥的时候，有些是不吉祥的时候。
There are good times, there are bad times.
有好的时候，有坏的时候。Rahu Kala,
you know Rahu Kala? Every day there's a time. Rahu Kala is the inauspicious time.
在每一天的全部的时刻里面，有一段叫做 Rahu Kala， 就是不吉祥的这个时候。You
want to avoid that time.
我们想要去避免那样的时候。
Well, it changes every day.
but
a good astrologer can tell you.
Well, get a good astrologer.
There's one astrologer I know. He has a website, Good Times, Bad Times. You just contact him. We often publish a calendar in Malaysia. We have a calendar and we always print good time every day, the time of Rahu Kala.
Oh, Chinese also similar idea, the lunar calendar, they say today good and what time good for what or not. Good for moving or not moving.
Yeah, time, there's good time.
Moving house or going to worship or do something.
We're just coming up to Purushottam month, right? The month of Purushottam, it's the additional month. It comes only once in every 3 years. There's an extra month, and it's considered a very inauspicious time for material things. Nobody will get married at that time, right?
我们现在的这个在印度的月历法里面是一个特别的叫 Purushottam。 这个月份是每三年会，就像我们说闰月一样，会多出来的一个月。但是这个月呢，要进行物质的活动是很不吉祥的。Yeah, no,
there's never a marriage takes place at that.
所以在这个Purushottam month，这个月份呢， 认为是不吉祥，说这个月呢，知道的人都不会去说进行婚礼。
So it's a very inauspicious time for business and material activity, but it's a very good time for spiritual.
嗯，啊，就是这个这段这个月份的那个时段里面，物质方面很不好，所以也不适宜做生意啊，不适宜做物质上的发展。但是是对灵性的发展是很好的。
People will take advantage of that month to do more chanting, to read scriptures, to worship more.
那人们就会更加好好利用这段时间呢，更加的念诵啦，研读经典啦，在灵性上的发展。啊，中国的农民历也是有类似。
Yes.
什么时间可以做什么祭祀拜拜，或是不能结婚，不能上送葬什么的。
Just like we have also the 3 months of austerity in Buddhism, right? They have 3 months of austerity. We have Chaturmasya.
那这个印度传统是有个四月苦行 ，Chaturmasya 有特别的啊，就是尽量来做灵修方面的部分。那就是佛教也有一些月份，就是说也是有那种比较限制性质的，然后也叫你多加的去做他们就做灵修的发展。
佛教在七月。
哦，七月。
我们那个 this year coming first time。
First time coming。So what can you learn from this? Well, we're learning, first of all, that there is a personality overseeing the creation and is taking charge, is helping and performing activities. And it's important for us to hear about it.
那如果今天的部分我们可以学到什么，就是让我们了解是有一个更高的权威，那有一个主哈，在掌管一切。然后呢，让我们去了解有神的存在，还有呢，我们要有进步，就聆听要非常，聆听是很重要的一个项目。
So kind of building on her question, if we accept from this story, we learn to accept that there are events caused by demonic people.Is there anything we can do? Or is there, you know, how can we, yeah.
How to kill them.
Yeah, do we just accept? Yeah.
他问说，既然我们面临的这个恶魔、邪恶之徒，那我们有没有什么方法来避免或阻止？
Well, of course, yeah, we know, if we understand who's good and who's bad, then we will know who to avoid and who to be with. We have that free will. We choose who we want to be with, who we want to associate with. You choose what example you want to follow, whose teachings, whose lifestyle you want to follow. Nobody's telling us you have to do this. You have that free will.You pick your own clothes, you eat your own food, you eat what you like to eat, you dress as you like to eat. And so it's the same way when it comes to actions and behavior and everything. We have that choice.
当然我们可以去分辨一般来说好人坏人啊，所以你有自己选择你要怎么跟他们交往啊，怎么避免这样。
Just like we're vegetarian, we don't eat meat, fish, and eggs. So even though people may offer us non-vegetarian foods, you know, we won't take it. You know, we're not inclined. We have our own standards. What we like to eat.
就好像我们是素食的，我们就会人家给我们的东西，我们不吃鱼肉蛋啊，我们就不会去接受这一类的这种食物。
Dressing is a bit different, you know. We eat to suit ourselves, but we dress for others. when it comes to dressing, usually you have to consider more about, you know, people you're working with and where you are, and so you will dress accordingly.
吃比较<咳>吃的话是比较为了自己，穿着呢比较为了别人。比方说我们考虑到我们去我们一起工作的同事们的，我们工作环境啊，跟你自己个人在家的环境不一样，就会去选择不同的衣服穿着，比较是要考虑跟别人之间的关系。So
there are different modes of nature. We describe from the teaching of the Vedas and Bhagavad Gita, we learn that the material nature is in three different degrees, that they're called goodness, and passion, and ignorance. Just like if you do painting, if you have three colors, three primary colors, red, blue, and yellow, from the three colors you can mix many other colors. By different combinations of the three primary colors, you can make green and brown, and it all comes from the three colors, the original three colors.
就好像在作画，这个颜料啊，各种颜色都是最原始的三个原色。 开始，然后各种不同的比例去混合呢，就产生各种不同的颜色，蓝色啦、棕色啦什么的，各种各样的颜色。And
the same way people are of different varieties.
同样的，在人方面呢，也是很多种的人。According
to our nature, we're drawn with, we act in different ways.
那根据我们每个人的本性呢，那就会有不同的方式去行为活动。So
in practicing Krishna consciousness, we're attempting to come more to out of the away from passion and ignorance, to come more to the mode of goodness.
在我们。 在练习 Krishna 知觉的程序的目标，我们试着要来脱离这个激情属性跟愚昧属性这些影响。And
then from goodness, then it's easier to transcend to come to the spiritual plane.
然后从这个善良属性的话呢，就更容易再提升。
去超越这物质属性到超然的部分。Okay.
I have one more question, but I'm hesitant to ask. Maybe it's a stupid question. But I wonder, in today's society, if you're looking at the average. What advice do you want to give them in general? What are some of the basic values or rules that you follow in Hinduism that you would love more people to know about?
Well, generally, we want people to understand ourselves not just simply as a material body, but to understand the passion, which is the living force within the body, a spiritual particle, an eternal spiritual being. We want them to understand that we haven't just simply lived, that life is not just once, but we're all eternal beings, and we've taken birth many times and in different bodies. Now we have this particular body, the human life, and the human life is special over other forms of life because it's an opportunity to inquire and to ask about who am I and why am I here and what, where am I going, what's going to happen to me when I die, particularly when we leave the body. where will I go, what will happen. So we believe in reincarnation. So we want people to understand these basic questions. First thing, to understand their identity. And then one them to, should also understand that there's God, there's a personality behind the universe who is the creator, who's the cause of the source of everything, and we have a relationship with him. So we encourage people to think about these kind of questions, to understand, who am I, who is God, is there a God? If there is a God, who is he, how can I know him?
身体，但是有一个在我们身体里面有一个生命力，那个生命力是谁？然后呢，我们也相信轮回来世，那就是说希望至少对先首先生物在这个世界认识自己真正的身份，然后将来还有来世，然后这个生命的目标目的是什么？这些概念基本上先让生物，让人们去了解这些。